Hey guys, Brockshield here, picking back up where we left off, the Holy Bible, King James Version. The second book of the Kings, commonly called the fourth book of the Kings, chapter 5. Now Naaman, captain of the host of the king of Syria, was a great man with his master and honorable, because by him the Lord had given deliverance unto Syria. He was also a mighty man in valor, but he was a leper. And the Syrians had gone out by the companies, and had brought away captive of the land of Israel a little maid, and she waited on Naaman's wife. And she said unto her mistress, "Would God my lord were that with the prophet that is in Samaria, for he would recover him of his leprosy." And one went in and told his lord, saying, "Thus and thus said the maid is of the land of Israel." And the king of Syria said, go, and I will send a letter unto the king of Israel." And he departed, and took with him 10 talents of silver, and 6,000 pieces of gold, and 10 changes of raiment. And he brought the letter to the king of Israel, saying, "Now when this letter is come unto thee, behold, I have therewith sent Naaman my servant to thee, that thou mayest recover him of his leprosy." And it came to pass, when the king of Israel had read the letter, that he rent his clothes, and said, "Am I God to kill and to make alive, that this man doth send unto me to recover a man of his leprosy? Wherefore I consider, I pray you, and see how he seeketh the quarrel against me." And it was so, when Elisha the man of God had heard that the king of Israel had rent his clothes, that he sent to the king, saying, "Wherefore hast thou rent thy clothes? Let him come now to me, and he shall know that there is a prophet in Israel." So Naaman came with horses and with his chariot, and stood at the door of the house of Elisha. And Elisha sent a messenger unto him, saying, "Go and wash in Jordan 7 times, and thy flesh shall come again to me, and thou shalt be clean." But Naaman was wroth, and went away, and said, "Behold, I thought, he will surely come out to me, and stand, and call on the name of the Lord his God, and strike his hand over the place, and recover the leper. Are not Abana and Pharpar, rivers of Damascus, better than all the waters of Israel? May I not wash in them, and be clean?" So he turned, and went away in a rage. And his servants came near, and spake unto him, and said, "My father, if the prophet had bid thee to do some great thing, wouldst thou not have done it? How much rather then when he said to thee, 'Wash, and be clean'?" Then he went down and dipped himself 7 times in Jordan, according to the saying of the man of God. And his flesh came again like unto the flesh of a little child, and he was clean. And he returned to the man of God, and said unto and all his company, and came, and stood before him, and he said, "Behold, now I know there is no God in all the earth but in Israel. Now therefore, I pray thee, take a blessing of thy servant." But he said, "As the Lord liveth before whom I stand, I will receive none." And he urged him to take it, but he refused. And Naaman said, "Shall there not then, I pray thee, be given to thy servant 2 mules burdened with earth? For thy servant will henceforth offer neither burnt offering nor sacrifice unto other gods, but unto the Lord. Is this thing the Lord pardon thy servant, that when my master goeth into the house of Rimmon to worship there, and he leaneth on my hand, and I bow myself in this house of Rimmon? When I bow down myself in the house of Rimmon, the Lord pardon thy servant in this thing." And he said unto him, "Go in peace." So he depart for a little way. But Bigahazi, the servant of Elisha, the man of God, said, "Behold, my master had spared Naaman, this Syrian, in receiving at his hands that which he brought. But as the Lord liveth, I will run after him, and take somewhat of him." So Gehazi followed after Naaman, and when Naaman saw him running after him, he lighted down from his chariot to meet him, and said, "Is all well?" And he said, "All is well. My master hath sent me, saying, 'Behold, even now there be come to me from Mount Ephraim 2 young men of the sons of the prophets, give them, I pray thee, a talent of silver and 2 changes of garments.'" And Naaman said, "Be content, and take 2 talents, and he urged them, and bound 2 talents of silver in 2 bags, and with 2 changes of garments, and laid them upon 2 servants, and they bore them before him. And when he came to the tower, he took them from their hand, and bestowed them in the house, and he let the men go, and they departed. But he went in and stood before his master, and Elisha said unto him, "Whence comest thou, Gehazi?" And he said, "Thy servant went no whither." And he said unto him, "Went now not mine heart with thee, when the man turned again from his chariot to meet thee? Is it a time to receive money, and to receive garments, and of the yards, and vineyards, and sheep, and oxen, and menservants, and maidservants? The leprosy therefore of Naaman shall cleave unto thee, and unto thy seed forever." And he went out from his presence as a leper as white as snow.